The West prospered for nearly 300 years. It was built through hardship, sacrifice, and on the backs of greats. But when mankind has achieved a level of greatness, it is destined to forget. Forget the values of those who sacrificed before them, and inevitably, destined to fall. Years of living in this land have faded the images in my mind of the world that once was. I was just a boy when the Great Split happened, when the walls went up, when the vocal minority became the dictators, and the outcasts became the forgotten. I have no memory of my father. Only of the man who found me, the one that taught me to survive. He, like so many other outcasts, lived long enough to have their spirits corrupted by anger and vengeance.
No!
Luther was a figure of fear in this land, a brutal barbarian of a man. But he wasn't the first. He told me a story. Story of a man who brought a philosophy of vengeance against those who dare enter these lands. Folks here gave him a name. They called him the Rider.
Help me.
2006, 2000, 1985.
Hey! You shouldn't be up and about yet.
Who are you, mister?
Name's Barrett. Barrett Roberts. What do I call you?
Beater.
Well, the bullet went through and through. I'm not sure what all it blessed on its journey through your gullet.
What, is that some poetic way of saying I might bleed through my gut or something?
Maybe, son. Just maybe. So what city are you from?
That obvious, huh?
Well, ain't nobody out here dresses like that, son.
New Providence, one.
Big city boy.
I was on my way to New Providence 33 when my transport crashed.
That's quite a jaunt, son. Ah, hell.
Hey!
Hey, old man!
B-R. B. Barrett. R. Barrett Roberts. Vain much?
Hungry? So, son, you never finished telling me what you're doing at New Providence 33.
I was part of a delegation. The Chancellor had new regulations coming down the pipe, and I was sent to make sure that the transitions went smoothly.
Mm-hmm.
So, how long you been in the Outlands, old-timer?
Oh, I came out here long before the WAC took over. Kind of lost track of the years.
Wow. So what's with the lunatic and the black relic? That vehicle looks like it's from the cowboy days.
You're talking about the Black Rider.
The Black Rider? Really?
Well, that's what they call him out here.
What the hell is his deal?
He came out here not long after WAC took over, when lawlenders like yourself started to come out here. I don't think he likes your kind.
Why? What the hell difference does it make?
Guess he's afraid.
Afraid?
Afraid if too many people like you come out here, you'll try to turn the Outlands just like the cities. Your tests, your class systems, your rules. The Rider, he won't let that happen.
You guys are all fucking lunatics out here. Why didn't he come down here then? If I'm such a great threat, is he too chicken shit to get out of his truck?
The Rider is a number of things, but chicken shit ain't one of them. If I had to guess, he was sizing you up.
What the hell kind of game is this?
Oh, no game, I imagine. You survived his initial onslaught. He's probably trying to figure out what kind of man you are.
What kind of man I... Yeah. Okay.
Son, there are two types of people out here. Those that come out here unwillingly. They tend to hold on to that life with everything they have and never really accept this life out here. Then you have the ones that reject that life, the ones that choose to do something different. They choose this.
Man, I didn't choose this backwoods Mad Max bullshit.
Backwoods bullshit? Hey now, you're talking about my home.
Sorry. Look, I just need to get to New Providence 33.
Let me ask you, son. What are you doing? Really? You live your life as a slave to the system. You gotta be here, you gotta be there. And for what? And for who? You? Or someone else? Life out here is simple.
Yeah. A little too simple, Gandhi. You got no running water, no electricity, no life.
Oh, son, but I have something you don't. Freedom. So, that it, son?
There's nothing left here for me, Barrett. Nothing.
So a city boy like you is not going to be any better out there today than you were the other day when I found you.
Thanks, Pops. I'll take my chances.
I guarantee you, you head out that way, you're not going to like what you find.
BR Black Rider.
Two-faced son of a bitch. Let me down.
I told you, son. There are two types of people that live out here. Those that repent the evil ways of the city, and those that don't. You really ain't willing to give that up?
Please, Barrett. Please. I don't want to die out here.
You had your chance, son. You rebuked me when you walked away from my offer of salvation.
You're a crazy old man. Hey. Hey, where are you going? Hey, you can't leave me out here! Barrett!
The writer has judged you, son. Found you wanting. Now the desert can deal with you.
No, I can change. I can learn. Barrett! No!
These men, like Barrett and Luther, they were the product of a society that failed them, and in turn, failed themselves. As it is said, hard times create strong men. Strong men create good times. Good times create weak men, and weak men create hard times. They could have chosen a different path, a path that could have steered them towards healing. Instead, they embraced the darkness. They did not know it, but they were the weak men. Me? Well, it's time someone broke that chain. I often think about the symbols we create, we follow, how they can be used for great evil. But I also think about how they can be used to teach, to inspire, to guide us through life. To remind us, we were placed here for each other. My hope, the writer can do just that.